So tell Snapchat how you felt when you was popping your not once, but two times on two different videos.
I have a 12-year-old
She's pretty.
Girl, daughter, who likes to twerk and post it on social media.
Woo! Now, if you treat your kids like this, 9 times out of 10, you're going to end up in a horrible nursing home being fed Jell-O and doo-doo. So, I mean, just saying. Yummy in this Chex Mix. I've had crumbs on my face, my bad. I can't wipe my face because I got makeup all up. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this, oh my God, I'm tired. This is my channel, and today we are going to be reacting to a mom embarrassing her daughter on Snapchat. Now, I deleted Snapchat a long time ago, and I ain't know people still really use that shit. Like, we got Instagram story, why we still using Snapchat? I don't know, maybe it's for the young folk. Whatever. Comment down below if you still use Snapchat. The only thing good about Snapchat is the filters, and I'll be just fine without it because I don't need no filter. All right. I'm probably not going to have this video on the screen because literally the daughter's face is very, very like on the screen 90% of the time. And I get a lot of comments talking about how I'm just as bad for not blurring these kids' faces out and blah, 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 which is crazy to me because it's like, their parents put their kids on the line by embarrassing them on the internet. That has nothing to do with me. The kids are already there. Whatever, I'm just reacting to it. It is what it is. If you don't like the way I do things here, you can clearly make your own channel and do your own shit and talk shit about me. Do what you want. That is the beauty of being in America or wherever you're from, where you can have freedom of speech and freedom to do whatever the hell you want. So for this one, I'm just going to not do it. Let me know if you guys care, don't care, because yeah, we're gonna see. I'm probably not gonna keep doing this, who knows? It'll probably be better for me to just blur the face, but that's way more work than just not showing the girl's face. Or maybe I'll just cut it, I don't know, we'll see how it goes. Comment down below if you care, comment down below if you don't. Maybe I'll have a card up there or whatnot, but just in case I don't. Also, keep in mind this is a reaction video. I will be pausing and doing all of that. If you want to see the full video, it will be down linked in the comment section, all right? Boom. All right.
What's up? So why is it a, so hold on, why did you Snapchat upload?
I didn't
feel the need to pop your ass on a video and post it on your Snapchat.
This girl looks so sad and so over it, but she don't look like she fazed at all. She do not look like she fazed.
So tell Snapchat what a 12-year-old should be doing with her ass. So tell Snapchat how you felt when you was popping your ass not once, but two times on two different damn videos.
Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. Woo! Now, I'm not about to sit, okay, Sage, what do you want? I'm not about to sit up here and act like I'm all grand and mighty and I wasn't out here twerking and shit. I was 12, hey. I don't think I was posting twerking on the internet. I wasn't, I didn't do that. But I was doing like some crazy things. Like I have bra pics you could probably find from my face online. And y'all probably like, wait, what? Yes, I used to post bra pictures all the time, like on MySpace. Like I love me a little bra picture with some jeans. I liked it. It was cute to me. All right. So if my parents would have dragged me for that back in the day, I would have been pissed. I would have been sad. I would have been crying. But at the same time, that's what like preteens and teens just do. Like not saying it's okay because now at this point, the internet is like way more advanced and there's way more pedophiles and all types of crazy stuff going on these days. And it's really not safe. But at the same time, it's one of those things where when it comes to like the twerking and dancing thing, all my friends used to do it. Back when I was growing up, that's when Baltimore Club was popping, okay? Jersey Club just started really getting popping. So we was like, what? We used to kill it. We used to be twerking. We used to be booty bouncing on the floor and splits and stuff. Like,
It was nothing. It was all fun and games. The adults used to be like, yes, get it. Like, it was never that bad. But now that I look back at it, it kind of is, especially if you put it on the internet. Like, I feel like if you're amongst an intimate crowd, there's nothing wrong with it, you know? If you're amongst your friends and family, you had a barbecue, you had a little birthday party, I don't think it's that bad. But if you're going to sit there and be, like, popping your coochie for the internet and sending it to boys and all of that, that's when it isn't as innocent as it should be. And I feel like that's the issue with it, because a lot of, like, these little girls be sending that to boys, and sometimes you don't know who the boy is, or sometimes the boy is a lot older, and you don't know what type of situation you could get yourself into. So I was like, damn, if my kid was to do what I was doing at 12, I probably wouldn't be too happy, but I can't be too much of a hypocrite, and I'd have to understand where the kid is coming from. But at the same time, the difference between me and kids these days is I wasn't sitting here posting stuff like that online. I was posting up bra pictures, and that ain't good, but I mean, in my defense, people post up bikini pictures, it's the same. Comment down below. Y'all probably gonna drag me, but it is what it is. At least I'm calling myself out. I did do a lot of questionable things as a kid, and if I had internet like this as a kid, it probably would be a lot more dangerous. So yeah, bro, look at Sage just wants me to pay attention to her. She is not having me doing this video right now. Can you like let me film so you can eat?
I don't know.
Parents don't like that response.
I'm confused. You took the time to prop up the phone, find music, turn your ass around in a motherfucking dress, and pop your ass in front of a camera. So, apparently you felt some type of motherfucking way. I want you to tell all your fucking friends how the fuck a 12-year-old feel popping her ass in front of a camera. Because maybe they want to know. I did start off with my name. My mother is trying to raise me better, but I don't want to be a motherfucking fox. Just in case they missed it, your name is what?
Okay, hold on. I'm sorry. Pause. Now, this is my issue with this, right? Not only is she sitting there putting her daughter on blast, she got a son in the background. Like, I guess she got another kid or another family member that could be anyone. I just saw a little boy walk past. Now, when you sit here and you degrade your daughter like this or a little girl like this in front of other people, it's way worse. And then if that's her younger sibling, you're not teaching him how to handle these types of situations well with females. I guarantee you if it was him doing the same thing and the roles were reversed, you probably wouldn't drag him like that. So my thing is, that's just horrible. And then on top of that, why are you outing your child's real name on the internet? Do you not know that she has to grow up and get jobs? Do you not know that she's eventually going to have to deal with this in the future? Are you dumb or are you dumb? Like, some of these parents just don't use their common sense. That's why it's like, I don't understand how y'all can be coming at me for making these videos when these parents are literally outing their children, name and all. They might as well give the kids freaking social. And I'm sorry if you guys are distracted by Sage. This is what she does. And if I did kick her out, she'd be crying at the door. And I just don't have time for it. So I'm sorry if this is distracting you. But it just doesn't really make sense to me. Because it's like, she is absolutely not giving her daughter the best advantage. Whether she stops doing what she's doing or doesn't. Like, it just doesn't make sense to me how people will do stuff like this. And then wonder why their kids hate them. And they're sitting in a nursing home with no visitors when they're 80 plus years old. And shitting on themselves. Like, if you treat your kids like this, 9 times out of 10, you're going to end up in a horrible nursing home being fed Jell-O and doo-doo. So, I mean, just saying.
Oh, and you like to what? In front of what? Why do you like to twerk in front of phones? Cause you a fast ass little girl, fast.
Ooh.
Who raised you?
Oh, this girl rolling her eyes at her mom like that? No, I'm sorry. Nah. You ain't about to roll your eyes at me, sis. At that point, I don't believe in putting my hands on kids, but she would have had to get punished for that. You're not about to be rolling your eyes at me, bro. No. Especially not when I'm trying to help you out. Well, kind of. Even though I don't really agree with the way she's doing it, but.
Because I'm a motherfucking fox. I aspire to be a fox. Where do you get your aspirations to be a fucking fox from? Why do you think it's appropriate to twerk your ass in front of a camera if you don't understand the question?
pause. I'm just gonna make a guess here that her daughter has access to the internet and has her own phone because clearly she has a Snapchat, right? If your kids have access to the internet, we all know what's on the internet, okay? Pussy popping, booty popping, thottery, okay? And then drugs and all types of stuff that kids shouldn't be seeing. To be upset by your kid exhibiting specific behavior that you are allowing them to consume, why are you letting them on the internet? It's a very simple concept. Comment down below if I'm like reaching, because like realistically speaking, if I let my child on the internet, then I'm going to have to know that my kid is going to be exposed to certain things that I'm not going to be happy with. And it's very hard to regulate the internet. I mean, you could put TV parental controls on TV. You can, you know, not expose your kids to the internet, but I mean, it's 2020. What are you gonna do at this point? And this video came out last year, so it's like, your kid is going to be exposed to the internet and your kid is going to access whatever they want. And if you're not giving them access to it, their friends have access to it. Like it's kind of hard to keep your kids away from certain things. But if you willingly allow your kid to have access to certain things, like the internet, you can't be mad when they consume it and reciprocate it if you are not actively telling them and speaking with them about these things. I highly doubt she saw her daughter watching the City Girls or, you know, listen to, you know, a certain song on the radio and was like, hey, I know you like this song, but what they're saying in that song ain't good. I know you like this dance, but this ain't appropriate for you. I'm very sure that a lot of parents would assume that this is common sense and they shouldn't tell their kids this. But a lot of things are not so common, especially for a child who is consuming things that, you know, they probably wouldn't deem as inappropriate. Like, I didn't know that twerking at 12 was bad. Like, I just saw it as something that everybody was doing. I saw it as a thing that was like, yes, like, this is dancing. Like, this is how we dance. La, 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 la. You know, it was never a thing that I was ever condemned for. My parents never said nothing to me about it. Other adults never said nothing to me about it. Like, that's just something we always did. It was all innocent and it was all fun. So, I don't know. I feel like it's crazy if she did it, because I wouldn't know if she spoke to her about this. But I know a lot of parents don't, and this is probably something I would have never thought to do. But now, if I have children, I'm probably going to do it. And all the kids around me, I'm probably going to tell them. Because I hear kids listening to Cardi B. I hear kids, you know, rapping to, like, really violent lyrics. And I'm just like, it catches me off guard, but at the same time, your parent is letting you consume this. Like, they'll be right next to their parents. And all you hear is, you can fuck with me if you wanted to. These is bloody shoes. Like, come on, bro. Like, and I just be sitting there like, you let your kid listen to Cardi B? Like, okay, I pop up with your party, I'm with the gang, and this will be a toe sucking chain. Come on, let's be real. Like, you let your kids listen to this type of stuff, and then when they go around robbing, killing, slutting, you get mad. It doesn't really make much sense. If you are gonna let your kids listen to this, let them know that this is not okay, this is not standard, this is not real life, and it's just a song. Because if not, you end up with these types of situations.
Your Snapchat friends me beating your fucking ass. If you want them to see your ass, I'm gonna show them me beating your fucking ass. But I don't wanna go to jail. Cause when I get through beating your ass, you gonna wanna call the fucking police. So tell Snapchat why you think it's appropriate to pop your ass in front of a fucking camera.
No, of course not if you get this type of punishment. Oh, this the mom. Okay.
I have a 12-year-old.
She's pretty.
Girl, daughter, who likes to twerk and post it on social media. I did not rape her like that. Just so y'all know. And going forward, if anybody got her motherfucking number, don't dial it, because she won't have a phone until she get good and grown and out of my motherfucking house.
Okay, well, all right, first of all, you should have thought of that before. I don't understand why people out here giving kids phones. I didn't get my real phone until I was able to afford my own. I used to use my mom's phone. I didn't get a real phone with internet till about like maybe high school. So that's that. Second of all, am I the only one, and am I wrong to think this, that these parents only care about themselves? They never say, I am so sorry for my daughter's behavior. I am so sorry for, you know, the way she is acting. It's always,
I didn't treat her that way to act that way to people. I did not raise her this way.
It's not about you. They always care about themselves. They don't ever care about the child. Like, it's so interesting how they're always like, oh, I didn't raise her this way. It's like, it's
not about you. It's about the kid that you clearly haven't been watching. That's why we're watching this. That's why she's twerking on internet. So it's like, it's not really about you per se. It's about this kid and what she's lacking to make herself do that. It's about this kid and why she thinks it's okay to do it. Because clearly now you're making her say these things. Now she knows that there's repercussions for twerking on the internet. Maybe she didn't think it was that serious before. Maybe she did. Maybe she got in trouble for this before. Maybe she didn't. You know, the point I'm trying to get at is, a lot of times, unless something is said to us verbatim, like, especially me, I'm that type of person, a lot of things, a lot of people be like, okay, but that's something you should have just known. Not to me. There's a lot of things that people have said to me or things that have occurred to me, and I'm like, oh, I never would have thought of it that way until someone explained it to me. Or there's things I've gotten in trouble for in the past, and it's like, oh, I didn't think that it was that serious. Like, I, you know, because I just genuinely did not see it that way. Like, so as a kid, you can imagine, you're not gonna see a lot of things being bad, especially if you see other people doing these bad things. So, I mean, comment down below, what do you think? I personally, like, but again, what do you think is the age that is appropriate for a person to have a phone? Like, what age you think a teen should have a phone? Because I see, like, 7-year-olds with iPhones, and I'm just like, well then, big pimp then, all right? But then again, it's like, you know, I understand why a lot of people give their kids phones because, you know, safety reasons, you know? But at the same time, it's like, you have to give your kid a freaking iPhone, and they're, like, 7. You know, you get them a little chirp. Like, I just don't think it's necessary to give your kid a smartphone necessarily, but I digress. If that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. Let me know what you think about this video down in the comments section below. Do you think her mom was right? What age do you think is appropriate for a teen to obtain a cell phone? And what would you have done to your kid in this situation? What I would have done is clearly take her phone away. Give her a little chirp because clearly she need to communicate. I don't want her getting snatched out in these streets. Because at this point, now, let's think about it now, all right? So you just outed your daughter. You said you're taking her away a phone. How about a predator is watching and he lives around the corner from you and she walks to school? And now he knows, oh, she ain't got a phone. I could snatch her because she can't call nobody. You see how that turns out to be a crazy situation? Now, a lot of you might be watching and you're like, oh, nah, that's a reach. That's a reach. But is it? Y'all don't watch Criminal Minds? I'm just saying. Like, it's not a reach. It's really not. A lot of times when you're outing your kids, when you're doing this type of stuff on the internet, you're basically opening the doors and the realms for other predators to come in and say some shit, to do some shit. You're making your kid vulnerable. So it's like, be careful when you drag your kids on the internet because you don't know who's watching. With that being said, make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, get your merchandise. Use code THEMAFIA for $15 off your order, or Mafia Lit for free shipping off your order. And I'ma see y'all next time. Say bye to the people. Say bye. 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 You're not gonna, she's not gonna say bye. She's just like, no.